Hello everyone. Once again, I welcome you all in Gokul Das Public School's structured syllabus-based online classes. So now it's time for maths lecture. So let's begin. In our previous lecture, we have learned the basics of addition and we learned some properties and we learned how to do addition. So and we have done some questions of exercise 2.1. Now we are going to continue. We have done till part B of question number 1 of exercise 2.1. Now we are going to deal with question number 1, part E. Once again, we are having three numbers, that is 14, 25 and 47, and we have to add them. We will write 1 below 1's position and 10's below 10's positions. Okay. Now, the very first step of addition, the very first step we do is we add 1's in 1's and then we add 10's in 10's. So, first of all, we will add 1's in 1's. So, how we do? What is written here? The first digit is 4. So we will draw 4 streets. Now the next digit is 5. So we are adding. That's why we will put plus sign here. Then the next digit is 5. So we will draw 5 streets. Now again we are having third number also. So once again we will put a plus sign and then we will draw 7 sticks. Why 7 sticks? Because 7 is written here. So let us draw 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. So let us count how many sticks do we have. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15 and 16. Our answer is 16. So as we learned in our previous lecture also, whenever we will get 2 digit answer, we will write 1 digit in 1's and the next digit in next digit column. And what we are doing, we are writing 1 digit in same group and then another digit in next group. It means we are dividing this 16 into 2 groups. We added all the numbers of only one group and now the answer we got, we are writing it in two groups. So what we are doing? We are regrouping. We will write 6 in this group and we will write this 1 in the form of carry in another group. So this process is called as regrouping. Why we are separating 1 and 6? Because in 16, 110 is there and 6 1's are there. So we are writing 6 in 1's column and we are writing this 1 in 10's column. Okay. Now 10's. Now it's turn for 10's column. So we will start from the very first digit, which is our K1. So we will draw 1 stick for this 1. Then our next digit is also 1. So again we will draw 1 stick. And we are putting addition sign. We are putting plus sign because we are doing addition. The next digit is 2. So we will draw 2 sticks. Now the next digit is 4. So how many sticks we will draw? Very good. We will draw 1, 2, 3 and 4 sticks. So let us count how many sticks are there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. 8 sticks are there. So we will write 8 here. So when we will add 14, 25 and 47, we will get 86 as answer. Now part F. First of all, we will write 10's in 1's column so that we cannot mess up all the numbers. So the first number they have given is 35. We will write tens below tens and ones below ones. Next number is 27. Again we will write tens below tens and ones below ones. And the next number is 15. So again we will write tens below tens and ones below ones. We will put a plus sign because we are doing addition. Now the very first step of addition is adding ones and ones. So let us start adding ones and ones. The very first digit here is 5. So how many sticks we will draw? We will draw 5 sticks. Now the next digit is 7. So how many sticks we will draw? We will draw 7 sticks. And the next number is again 5. So we will draw again 5 sticks. Now let's count how many sticks do we have. Let's count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15 and 16. I think we and 1 I left 17. Okay, let's count one more time. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16 and 17. How many sticks do we have is 17. So did I write 17 correctly or should I write this one here? No, because we got two digit answers. So we have to regroup that two digit because we can only write one digit here. Okay, so now it's time for the tens column. So we'll start from this carry. We will draw one stick, then we will draw 1, 2, 3 sticks, then 2 sticks, then 1 stick. Now let's count. And I think you are getting why I am putting this dash type mark here, so that if, as I forgot this earlier, I forgot to count this one. So I checked whether I have counted all the sticks or not. So those who are not having this dash type mark, we will get that. We are not counted that and we will count that one. So for doing this dash kind of mark, we can avoid mistakes. Okay, so now let's count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. So when we will add 35, 27 and 15, our answer will be 77. G and H you can do by your own. I'm going to do I for you. Again we will write tens and ones, and then we will write tens below tens and ones below ones. So 16, 24 and 9. Here in the third number no tens digit is there, so we will not write anything here. Okay, so now we will draw 6 sticks, then 4 sticks, then 9 sticks. Okay, now let's count how many sticks. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18 and 19. Again we got two digit answers. So what we will do? We will do regrouping. Regrouping in ones and tens. Okay. Now let's count these tens. We will draw sticks for tens. And now let us count how many sticks are there. 1, 2, 3 and 4. So we will write 4 here. So whenever we will add 16, 3, 4 and 9, our answer will be 49. Now, part J. Now, three columns are there. 100, 10 and 1. Till now what we are doing? We were just dealing with two columns. But this third column will also remain same. Whatever we are doing, we will doing the same. So, as we were writing tens below tens, ones below ones, so likewise we will also write here 49 as tens below tens and ones below ones. Our next number is 56, again tens below tens, ones below ones. Now the next number is 82, tens below tens and ones below ones. So again the very first step will be adding all the ones. So first of all, I am not here having sufficient step, that is why I am drawing sticks here. 9, so we will draw 9 sticks, then the next number is 6, so we will draw 6 sticks, then the next number is 2, so we will draw 2 sticks. Now let's count how many sticks do we have. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16 and 17. So we got two digit answer. So what we will do? We will regroup that 17. Okay, so how we will regroup that? We will write 7 in ones group and 1 in tens group. Okay, so now it's turn for tens column. So 1 is there, so we will draw 1 stick for it. Now next digit is 4, so let's draw 4 digit, then the next digit is 5, so we will draw 5 sticks, and then the next digit is 8, so we will draw 8 sticks. Now let's count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, and 18. Now again we got 2 digit answer. We added 1 digit and we got 2 digit answer. So we will again regroup this 2 digit answer. So we will write 8 below tens and 1 in the form of carry below hundreds, and no digit here, only 1 is there, so nothing is going to add in 1, so our answer will remain 1 in the hundreds column. So when we add 49, 56 and 82, our answer will be 187. Three sticks, Now 5 is there, so we will draw 5 sticks. Now 8 is there, so we will draw 8 sticks. Now let's count how many sticks do we have. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. And 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16 and 17. So again we got 2 digit answers. So we will regroup 17 like this. We will write 7 below 10s and 1 in the column of hundreds in the form of carry. So no digit is there, so we will write 1 as it is. Now I hope you are able to do the rest of the parts of question number 1 of exercise 2.1. So rest of the parts you can do by your own. Now the exercise 2.2 is also same as 2.1. So let's try some question of exercise 2.2. Now the very first question of the exercise is, add the following. The same question in the exercise 2.1 we were adding 2 digit number. Now in exercise 2.2 we are going to add 3 digit numbers. So first question, part A. First of all we will write the places 100 tens and ones. Now the first number is 638 and second number is 361. Now the number of digits are changed. Earlier we were dealing with 2 digits, now 3 digits are there, but the process will remain same. Number of digits may vary, but the process of addition will remain same. First of all we will add ones in ones, then we will add tens in tens, and then we will add hundreds in hundreds. So let us add ones in one. For adding, how we will add? We will add by drawing sticks. So the first digit is 8 here, so we will draw 8 sticks. Now 1 is there, so we will draw 1 sticks. Now let us count how many sticks are there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. So we will write 9 below ones because we have added this ones digit. So we will write below ones only. Now it's turn for tens place. So 3 is written first, so we will draw 3 sticks for it. Now we are doing addition, that is why we will put plus sign. Then the next number is 6, so we will draw 6 sticks. Now let us count how many sticks are there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. 9 sticks there, so we will write 9 below 10's column. In the 10's column, below 10's position, when we will add 1's in 1's, we will write answer below 1's. When we will add 10's in 10's, we will write answer below 10's. And now when we will add hundreds in hundreds, we will write our answer below hundreds. Okay, so the first digit here is 6. Now the next one is 3. So let us add and count how many sticks are there. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. So when we will add 638 and 361, our answer will be 999. Now this process of drawing sticks is our rough work. We are not going to show in our fair work. This drawing sticks and counting stick work is rough work. Now part C. Again we will write 100 tens and ones first, then we will write numbers 891 and 108. I'm drawing sticks here. I'm not here having sufficient space. That is why I'm drawing sticks here. So one is there. So we will draw one stick. Adding there. So we will put plus sign. Now it is there. So we will draw 8 sticks. Now let's count. How many sticks are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. So we have added ones. So we will write this 9 below ones position. Now the next 9 plus 0. Remember, do you all remember the addition fact, the property of addition? Zero property. Whenever we add zero to any number or number is added to zero, our answer will remain number itself. So here we are adding 0 to 9, so our answer will be 9. Now 8 plus 1, order property. Do you remember about order property? Whether I add 1 in 8 or 8 in 1, answer will remain same. Whenever we put the numbers before 8 or after 8, our answer will same. So whether I need 1 in 8 or 8 in 1, answer will be 9. So here we use two properties, zero property and order property.
Five. The next number is 725.
11. Okay. So 5 plus 1. Whenever 1 is added to any number, we get its successor. Remember the property of addition. You can, if 1 is added to any number, whenever 1 is added to any number, it gives its successor. So now we are using that property. So 5 is added to 1. So what is successor of 5? 6. So we will write 6 here. 2 plus 1. Whenever 1 is added to any number, it gives its successor. So what is successor of 2? 3. Very good. Now, whenever 1 is added to any number, it gives its successor. So 7 plus 1. So what is successor of 7? Very good. 8. So we will write 8 here. Now you can say like that, ma'am. 7 here. 7 is not 1. 1 is going to add in 7. It's not written like this. It is like this. So this and this are equal by order property. So whether we add 1 in 7 or 7 in 1, it is same. So we are using two properties here, order property and successor property. So we can do addition even without drawing sticks also. If 1 1 is written there, whether upside or downside, on the first position or second position, whether 1 is in first addend or second addend, we can do that. We can do that without drawing sticks by successor property. Now part H. Again we will write 110s and 1s, 581 and 105. Now again 1 and 5 is there. So whenever 1 is added to any number, it gives its successor. So what is successor of 5? Very good. 6. So we will write 6 here. Now 8 plus 0. Whenever 0 is added to any number, the answer will be number itself. So 8 plus 0 is 8. Now 5 plus 1. Order property, 1 plus 5 is 6. So 5 plus 1 now will also be 6. How simple it is? So that we can avoid the mistakes. If 581 and 105. So for writing properly, we are writing the places 110s and 1s. So part I, 612 and 387. Now 7 plus 2. So I am drawing 7 sticks and 2 sticks. So let us count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. So we have added 1. So we will write 1s below 1s. Now 1 plus 8. Whenever is 1 added to any number, it gives its successor. So what is successor of 8? 9. Very good. Now 6 plus 3. So draw 6 sticks and 3 sticks. So let's count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. So we'll write 9 here. Okay. Now part 847 and 122. 7 plus 2. So let's draw 7 sticks and 2 sticks. we have we draw 7 sticks and 2 sticks because 7 and 2 is written there. Now let's count 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 and 9. So we will write 9 below ones because we have added ones. Now 4 plus 2. So we will draw 4 sticks and 2 sticks. Now let's count 1 2 3 4 5 and 6. So we will write 6 here. We will write 6 below tens because we have added tens. Now 8 plus 1. Whenever 1 is added to any number, it gives it successor. So what is successor of 8? Very good, 9. So we will write 9 here. Now part K. 100 tens in ones. 847 and 122. 7 plus 2. We just did 7 plus 2. What was the answer? Answer was 9. So we will write 9. 4 plus 2. Okay. Sorry. Oh, I wrote the same numbers again. We are going to do was K. So K is 546 and 242. So 6 plus 2. How we will add? We will draw 6 sticks plus we will draw 2 sticks. Now let's count how many sticks are there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. 8 sticks are there. So we will write the number 8. Now 4 plus 4. We will draw 4 sticks and again we will draw 4 sticks. Now let's count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. How many sticks are there? 8 sticks. So we are going to write the number 8. Now 5 plus 2. We will draw 5 sticks and we will draw 2 sticks. Now let's count how many sticks are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. 7 sticks are there, so we will write the number 7. Now likewise you can do the remaining part of this question number 1, and with this we have finished exercise 2.2 also. In exercise 2.1 we did 2 digit addition with 3 grouping, and 2.2 we did addition without regrouping. 2-digit addition and 3-digit addition are the same. The only difference we are having is that there is no hundreds column in 2-digit number, and in 3-digit number there is 100 column. But the addition process is same. First of all, we add ones in ones, then we add tens in tens, and if their hundreds column is also there, we will add hundreds in hundred. So till then, we will meet in next lecture. Till then, all of you stay home, stay safe, and keep practicing. Bye bye, students.